Thanks for the introduction. Good afternoon, everybody. How is the Josh? So the afternoon sessions are always challenging. And to keep all of us awake, we will have some initial questions to start with. So the purpose of this presentation is to understand the building blocks, how AI can be our financial advisors. Because if we try to hire a financial advisor, one is it's very costly, and also they try to sell their own products like SDFC, they will sell you ULIP. So ULIP is not a good product. So we'll see how AI can help us do that. So let's answer these questions. So I would like you to participate and raise your hands for the same. First one is, how many people have housing loan or have taken in the past? Can we have raise of hands? So you keep your hands up only. So, and how many of you have credit cards? How many of you have personal loans? So it's like everybody has raised their hands. So with that, this hypothesis is getting proved. We have this statistics which shows like the household liabilities have been increasing, and the savings of an Indian individual is reducing. And here also we can see 57% have savings less than 5,000 rupees, and only 4% are having more than 5 lakhs of the saving. So why is this happening? One is, we are not taking charge of our own finances. So before we deep dive into and see the models and understand, before that we need some foundational base. So this is just an example from American statistics, where we can see the median American household spending, how is it divided between different expense components. So for them, housing is 31%, taxes is 26%. So taxes is same for India as well. And then transportation, again, that's travel. And now for India as well, it's increasing for the middle class public because we're going around the world. Then food and other expenses. Healthcare in India would be less compared to America's. So how machine learning can help save more money? So the approach what I have followed is unsupervised learning, where we can cluster our data, and after clustering we can label it and do visualizations which can help us understand how and where our money is going, and which can help us decide and reduce our expenses. So the key important part in this is data set. We have a lot of good algorithms, but what should be the data set? So any guesses what can be the data set? Yeah. So we know the answer, but do we analyze our bank statement for the span of like 5 years? Okay, good. But I can see only one hand. So bank statement for salaried people and like the people who have white money is a very valid data set which can help extract features, and we can create models which can help us in prediction, and then we can decide that how can we reduce our expenses and intelligently invest money in the right asset instead of illusions which banks are giving us. So bank statement has few of the key attributes, and In machine learning terminology, we call it as features. So we have to extract like withdrawals, deposits. Once we do that, and if we apply unsupervised learning, we can cluster the data, we can group it. And after we group it using Tableau, we can get good insight about our data. Supervised learning is long way to go from the perspective where we need the classification, and the classification can only be done based on expense and income, which can't give much insight. But there can be like a lot of research done in that area. But I am scoping, my scope would be unsupervised learning. So if you see this chart, it is like chart of 5 years of total expenses an individual has spent. So these are the expenses would be mandatory. But if we deep dive, we can find some expenses which can be reduced. But you can see this housing loans, right? So it's like 10% of the total income an individual is paying in housing loans. 7% he is paying in credit cards, then car loan. So this is the area which we can focus on and reduce it. However, how should we do that? The main thing is using the simple models of unsupervised learning, we can achieve it. So the data set is your own bank statement. Maybe you can do this exercise by your own self. You can run a model in R, a clustering model, get your data cleaned, like you can get withdrawals, deposits, and run a KNN, and you will get clusters like this. And then you have to label it. So as of now, I have manually labeled it, but there are NLP also models available where you can extract the narrations and it can be automatically labeled. So that will go in supervised learning. So once your data set has like been cleaned and we have run an unsupervised model, I've put the same in Tableau, and this is just the full chart view, which gives us a clear understanding how a person is spending their money and where is the area where he can reduce it, right? Going forward into this chart, which is related to housing loan. So this individual has like had one house and he has paid almost 20 lakhs of EMI, and he purchased one more house as he moved that city, right? And the total EMI which he has paid is 25 lakhs. Now, if we can get a view like this through our models, or we can create by ourselves for our own benefit, then we can see what is the opportunity cost. Sometimes we take financial decision in haste and comparison, like my friend has bought a house, so I should also buy one. However, we really need to understand whether that house has value which will be a right investment or right asset. And what I have done is I have just compared this with investing in PPF, right, which gives you 8% of rate of interest. So if you invest in it the same amount, which like 50,000, so I start with 50,000, slowly the amount gets increased, added up, and so my capital is increasing. Along with that, my interest has started, right? So having two houses, how will it help? Instead of that, if we have this recurring income. We can keep our wives happy, and if they are happy, we'll be happy, who are married, and for non-married girlfriends happy. So also the other investments you can make in investing in yourself as well. So these are the benefits which we already talked about, like we can compare housing investment with other investments, and which can help us take an informed decision whether house is the right asset or we should invest in any other asset which can give us better returns. Moving to credit card. This is my favorite. So credit card, we can see by this simple visualization how this individual has spent the money. Like, he started slow in 2016, but then he got the habit of spending more, and slowly that habit is increasing. And who will take the advantage? Banks. And what are we doing here is, we, once we run these models and deep dive into it, we can find ourselves that some of these expenses are really not needed. And the average is around 35,000 rupees for an individual, right? So how, if we use this visualization, like we get a view of our credit card expenses of 5 years, and then average trend between the expenditure and the limit, and which can help us also forecast like what would be our credit card expenses in future. We will see, we have a very simple model where we can see, once we forecast it, we what will be our credit card expenses for next 2 years. The main benefit is for banks. So banks are, can use this data in understanding the credit card expense pattern. What we saw, easily they can see that this person has got addicted to the credit cards, and based on which they can also see some trends where his expenses are more, like festival, this, yeah, this is the festival time when the expenses gets increase. So giving more discounts would help bank raise more money. And then sometimes what they do is that once we become habitual, then they don't waive off our late payment. Sometimes we get late payment, like late in paying the amount. So if we have these simple models which we can run by our own self, this will really help all of us to understand our own expenses, getting a view. We try to sometimes struggle to get a data set, but sometimes this is the real time data set which we have. You can get your 5 years, 10 years bank statement and run in R, and once you get the clusters, label it and visualize in Tableau, you can get your answers by your own self. Then here we can see, once we do the forecasting, we can see this, the same graph based on the time series format. It's like the forecast is coming is like 38,000 every year on, sorry, month on month basis that individual will be spending. So by this, we can also see how we can try reducing this amount. So the tools which I have used is, are, I've tried like running some supervised models in Python, but I didn't got good results. So I'm not sharing that with you guys because it was a regression problem, and from a classification perspective, there was not good results. It was just giving about expense and categorization between expense and income. And then I've used Tableau. So these are all open source, so we all can use, and I'm assuming like most of us are from machine learning background and we might be already been using this. From a future work perspective, the plan is to get a finance app which can take users' bank's account and get it uploaded. And yeah, there will be a security issue, but that once we get that app in place, then we can fix that as well. So the bank statements would not be shared with others. And then we'll start with unsupervised learning, and we'll also see how we can have models for supervised learning as well, and which can help individuals in getting an like app at your hand. And if you just upload your bank statements, you'll be able to get the details. So, yep, that's pretty much it from my side.